Hey guys, welcome to my live Pilates class, we'll wait a few minutes to get everyone to log on and sign in. Grab your things if you're starting to get ready, so grab a towel, you can grab your mat if you have a mat or you have a towel for your back. We suggest if you have any spine issues, you can grab a book for later. So you can sit on top to adjust your spine if you can't sit upright. Or if you have a foam roller at home, or you can use a mat and fold it behind you. But just in case, prepare everything now so that later you don't have to walk around so many times to walk and look for things. And of course, your water. Hi everyone, hello. To know you, baby. I see you're ready, yes. Well, if you're starting to get ready, why don't you lay down on your mat and start your breathing. Lay down on your back, okay? Nice and long. Relax your head, shoulders, abs contracted, and just start your breathing in through your nose and out through your mouth. Avoid breathing through your stomach. Or through your ribs going up and down. Think about ribs going wide. Continue to do that a few times as everyone else starts to sign in and gets ready for the class. Remember, you're breathing in through your nose and out through your mouth and have your lungs filled with air and have your ribs go wide. So think like an accordion. You want to get your ribs to go outside of each other and back together. Don't go forward and down. Hello, hello, hello. Continue to breathe. So this class today is gonna focus a lot on core. A lot of us need core work. I'm gonna make you sweat and then think about centering yourself and that you have good alignment. You can be able to move your appendages much easier and freely. I want you to lessen your lower back pains. So let's see how we can do this class with good progressions. I'll regress some movements if it's too hard, based on how I would feel with you if you were in my class to begin with. So let's see how this goes, all right? So again, there's three or four more breaths. We have a few more people logging on. If you're just logging in, welcome to my Pilates class. I want you to think about how you're gonna start to lay down on your mat, facing down on your back, facing up with your face, and think how you're gonna breathe in through your nose and out through your mouths. Good. I want to take a nice deep inhale and then exhale. When you exhale, remember you want to fill the lungs with air and exhale, with your ribs going out to the sides. So think how you're going to go out. So don't go here. Go away and back down. So you can take your hands on top of your body, if anything, to feel yourself going. So see how my elbows move to the sides, away from my center. Good, just keep breathing that way. Let's do two more nice deep breaths. Hi Jenny, all the way from the US. Hi Bowie. Good. All right, last breath, inhale. And exhale. Good. Let's start with our legs hip width apart, knees facing up, heels even. Think about making triangles with the back of your legs. Rest your head down, hands in front of you. So think you're gonna reach your hands up to the ceiling, lengthening through your fingertips and arms, but don't pull your shoulders up. Keep them nice and neutral to the sides, and then back down towards the floor. So inhale to prepare your movements, exhale to lift straight up. Good, if you're more flexible, you're gonna go towards your ears, but don't arch your back. So think you're gonna use your abs and push down to your center to really get your back to lengthen. So keep your back nice and long on the mat. So inhale, exhale your hands straight up. I'm gonna avoid arching your back. So think how you're gonna reach without having that lift. So squeeze those abs if you need to get into a deeper long back. So lengthen your spine. Good, inhale, exhale, up. Inhale, exhale, down. So think about controlling your breathing as you control your movement. So go up and down. Let's do two more. Inhale, exhale, up. Inhale, exhale down. So really good for your shoulders to get them sort of mobilizing, lubricating your joints. Last one, up. And down. Let's go to your chest lift. So take your hands, interlock your fingers together, piston behind your head. Same thing, on an inhale, exhale, pick up the crown of your head, reaching up and over like you're scooping over a ball. Get the shoulder blades off the floor and then soften back down as you breathe back out. Inhale, exhale, push air out as you lift up tall. So chest lift and then slowly lower down. Keep going on your own. Think about you pushing your hips into the floor square. Good, I'm gonna take my head off, back of my head. Good, my neck. Tops of my shoulders gonna curl over, ribs are pushing down, so I'm gonna really contract your abs. Inhale at the top, exhale down slowly. So don't think about it as a big, fast ab workout, think how you control. So we really wanna work the upper back. Good, and then soften back down with your head down last. So head comes up first, think about the gaze going forward towards your knees. Keep that gaze long, and then go right back down. Think there's an egg on your neck, don't squash the egg. Keep lengthening up and over, pushing forward. And back down. So good for your abs, good for your back, good for your core. So control, center, yeah? So think like the core is the front and back of your body. So you really wanna work and strengthen that center. Let's go two more times. Inhale, exhale up. Inhale, exhale down. Last one, inhale, exhale up. Inhale, exhale down. Let's go to your chest lift and hold statically. So inhale, exhale up. Center yourself, take your hands forward. You're gonna pulse down for your hundreds. Inhale for five pulses. Exhale for five. You can flip your wrist up and down for every five. Control. So it's called 100 for a reason. We do 100 pumps. So keep breathing in and out. Remember, you're gonna get those shoulder blades up and over, abs tight. Reaching forward with those arms to give yourself a little bit more extension up into your spine as you contract those abs and pull that belly button into the floor. We have three more sets. Two. Last 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. You can take your hands behind your head and slowly lower down. Again, inhale, same idea. Exhale up and over. Inhale and exhale. Control. Remember, you want to use those abs to stay lifted. Don't strain your neck. If your neck is tired, get yourself to look a bit higher. Or if you need to just hold yourself up with those hands behind your head and really hold the contraction, keep your breathing, okay? So remember, you're resting your hands on your neck like a pillow. So don't push your hands to lift your head up. Four more times. Three more times. Two more times. Last 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Let's make this a bit harder. So think about your legs going up to the ceiling, okay? So when I think about tailbones pushing into the ground, same thing, inhale, exhale to your chest lift, look up and forward, take the hands off and pulse. Keep breathing, keep energizing your body to hold your center up. Come on, guys, you can do this. I know you can do this. Don't just watch, do it. Come on, sweat with me. Four, three, two, last 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Give yourselves a nice hug. Bend those knees in. You can move side to side if you need to. Good. Let's get harder with this, yeah? So your legs up, okay? Same thing, you can turn your feet apart. I want you to have the heels touch, okay? So turn on your toes. I want to go up into your chest lift. My legs are going to go lower down for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come up, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And push, 2, 3, 4, 5. Keep going. Make sure your lower back is on the mat. So don't arch your back. Go as far as you can down with your legs without arching your back. If your back arches, that's your maximum range. Stop. Pull your legs back up slowly. So everyone's different, so think about how you're gonna lengthen your legs down and up, okay? Four more, go down, two, three, four, five, and up. Two, three, four, five, and down. And up. Remember, use the abs down. And up.
Last one, down and up. Let's stay here, bend your knees to tabletop. Good, reach up and forward, take your hands behind your head. I want to go to a crisscross. Opposite shoulder to that nice straightened neck and the opposite knee, and switch. So then you're pushing your pedals in front of your body with control. Reach your shoulder up to the knee, keep your hips square. We're gonna start with a slow extension of each side of the legs. Four, three, two. Let's add tempo, go. Eight, seven, six, five. Keep reaching up, four, three. Keep the head up, two, one. Hold, oh. Good, let's bring both legs up and switch and hold. Up, switch and hold. So when we go up, look at your legs, other side, rotate. Bring those legs up, down, switch and hold. I'm gonna pull that belly button in. Up and switch and hold. We have four more, up, switch and hold. Three, up, switch and hold. Two, up. Think about those hips and legs. Last one, up, switch and hold. Let's go back to your crisscross, go eight, seven, six, five. Come on guys, come on, you can do this. Four, keep going, get that center in, get a bit warm. Three, two, last eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, and rest. Again, move yourselves around if you need to, or just hold your center, squeeze those knees in to run your back a bit. Good, let's go with one leg in, one leg out, knees even over the hip, hip square on both sides and balanced. So take your hands over your knee and your shin. I want to pull up into your chest like we did earlier. Hold your center down. So nice single leg stretch, pushing here. Inhale, exhale, and switch. Think of something thick in front you want to push yourself out of. And switch. And switch. So I'm pulling and pressing the opposite leg away. So it's energy in my hands, working my biceps and my abs. Moving through the hips. Tensing the legs, so there's muscle control even in my quads. Let's go faster and go. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. We're gonna keep moving. Take the leg you're holding, stretch it up and switch. Hold and switch. Go, switch. Switch. If you're more flexible, you can grab your calf, but watch out for the hips. Keep them square on the ground. Four more, guys. Come on. Keep working. Push and pull. Two more. Push and pull. Last set. Push and pull. And rest. Are you guys warm? I'm already sweating. Good? Let's keep going. Let's go for your bridging, okay? Let's go with your legs, hip width apart, knees up to the ceiling. Pull your abs in, hands on the ground, widen your chest. So think how you push yourself and your tailbone up, pushing forward with the knees. Don't go too high up, so don't want to arch my back. I want to keep myself long. From here, I'm going to roll down from my chest as I breathe out. Tailbone down last. Inhale. Exhale, press, push your tailbone up, one bone at a time to the ceiling. At the top, inhale, exhale from your chest, roll down slow. So think you're gonna snake your body up, so bring your tailbone up, bone by bone, so every vertebrae in your back wants to come off the ground, and then wants to go back down. So think how you snake yourself, but think about tailbone going up, driving up, everything's gonna follow to lengthen through your spine. Inhale here, from your chest, you want to roll down, tailbone down last. A few more, inhale, exhale, up. Really good for your back to mobilize it. Really good to alleviate any disc pressure in your lower back. And good spine mobility. Control, take your time, pushing up, lengthening your spine at the top. Knees going towards your toes. So think you push yourself forward. Remember, avoid arching at the top, okay? So don't arch your back. Lengthen your spine. Feel your spine stretch away. So think about your knees push forward towards your toes as you peel up. Keep the energy in those heels to sort of slow yourself down. So the more you push your feet down, the more you actually get to separate your vertebrae, lengthening through your spine and controlling this pressure. This is a really good movement to feel good through your whole body at the same time. My glutes are firing, my hamstrings, my quads. Push your abs, control, squeeze. Two more. Inhale. Exhale up, pushing up tall. Give me last one. Good, let's make this a bit harder by progressing it. If you have any back issues, think about you can stay with both legs on the floor. So inhale, exhale, up. Good, I'm gonna take one leg off the mat. Okay, keep the hips square. I wanna flex my foot and go down. Match the height of both knees. Point and come up. Flex and point down. And point up. So as you go down up with that leg, same leg, then you're gonna flex your foot and point your toes to come up. Or they go down to match the height of both knees and go up to the ceiling 90 degrees, okay? Don't kick, control your muscles. Push forward and up. Inhale, exhale, lower that leg down. Think of your foot like a paintbrush. Make a nice straight line, so you wanna work and control. Last two. Last one. Good, let's bring that leg down slow, even sides, you can rest. Good, let's prepare your other side, inhale, exhale, peel up for your bridge. Good, inhale, exhale, lengthen the leg up, control your hips, and go down for eight, and point up, seven, and point up. Then you're pushing that heel away, so you really wanna stretch your leg forward. But don't drop your hips. Keep them even on both sides. You can take your hands on the top of your hips to hold them. Not to hold them, sorry. To see how they move. Make sure they stay square. Good, let's do four more. Three more. Two. Last one. Good, let's soften the leg down with control. Roll down from your bridge. Good. Let's go with your book openings, okay? So think about your knees are going to be up to the ceiling. Hips stay square. One leg's going to push. One leg's going to open. But don't open the hips to drop. Keep both hips on the ground. So it depends on how flexible you are. One leg is pushing. One leg is opening. Good. Bring that leg back up to the center. Keep the heel strong on that other side. And lower the leg to the other side. Open the hip. You can take your hands on the top of your hips, so make sure they're both controlled. So you don't want to overwork. Just using gravity to help you stretch the hips. Breathing in and out. Use your abs to control your center. Keep your spine long on the mat. Think how you're going to feel good by giving a nice stretch to those hips. Good, two more, nice and controlled, open. Last set. Good, let's bring those legs up the tabletop. So knees over hips, okay? With control, take your hands behind your head. I wanna peel up and look at my knees. We're gonna do one more hundreds. So this is a bit more relaxed on the legs, but keep them nice and over your knees. With the hips nice and square, hands in front, and pulse. Keep breathing in. And out.
Let's go for 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Good. If you need to take a rest, take those legs down. If you want to still work harder, I want to take my hands in a circle away from my head to reach, then bring them back. I want to use my legs to push away and then pull and push and pull. Good. 4. Keep the head up. 3, 2, 1. Good. Let's kick up to sit. Good job. Let's all face down to the mat. We're gonna facing down on your stomachs. When you're facing on the ground, always pull your abs off the floor so this helps you support your back and work your abs still, okay? So we're gonna do a basic a prone press up. So when I start with my legs laying down, my head is gonna hover over the floor. My fingers and palms by my chest, elbows squeeze in. Like I'm making 2 grasshopper legs, okay? Squeeze those elbows in, helps you tone the arms and work harder into your upper back to extend. The thing about your forehead is gonna come off the ground first, so squeeze those abs, inhale, exhale, bring your head up, looking forward, balance on your lowest rib, and then soften back down. Inhale, exhale, and lift. And lower. So we're working your upper back. Inhale, exhale, lift up your head. Think of your extend to look forward and back down. Push your lower rib into the ground. So you want to think about upper back, so extending up. Then you want to grab the box of cereal at the top shelf, so you need to look up, right? So the same idea, lifting up to look, and then softening down. Remember, get those shoulders nice and wide, tensing the arms, and push into the ground. Use your abs, support your back. Let's do 3, inhale, exhale, up, and down, 2 more. Good, last one. Good, let's energize our hands and get our whole body off into a swan. So inhale, exhale, get your whole body off, pushing your hands, lengthening up, keep those abs tight, and then soften down with your head last. So then you're gonna look into the ground, draw a line from the floor to the front of your room, nice and tall, as you push those hands off, get those elbows to straighten with your arms, and then soften down, so really resist. So I'm using my hands to go down slowly, so I'm still feeling that stretch and extension in my back. So swan all the way up. Try to get your hips off the floor. Don't do a cobra. So I want to resist cobra, so get everything to the left and squeeze and soften. 2 more. Inhale, exhale, up, push away. Come down slow. Remember, use those abs, support yourself. Inhale, exhale, up. Good, and come down. Let's add a bit of a neck stretch. So when you go up, if you can go all the way up here, hold. If your wrists are tight, you can make 2 fists. I want to look to the side or one shoulder. Keep the shoulders, the hips square. Center yourself, inhale. Exhale, look the other way. Good, back to the center. And switch. With control, right? So inhale, exhale. Get yourself to look to the side. Keep those abs in. So almost like a baby plank, right? Your knees are still on the ground, but you want to look side to side. So really working your core, your arms, as you stretch your neck. So I'm trying not to let you focus on your plank. I want you to focus on your neck. So really brace yourselves with that center, squeeze those abs in, and go side to side. Good, give me 2. Last set. Good, center, and start to come down slowly. Good, you can go to your child pose. Take your hips to your heels, stretch out your back, your shoulders. Nobody's making you. Nobody's making you. Good, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Let's take a center up. I want you to take one hand under one side and start to lengthen back. Stretch out that shoulder, rotation in the upper back. Push your hips back into your toes. Five, four, three, two, one. Good reset. Soften yourself back forward. Other side, and start to lower down. If you can reach through, look to your other side with that neck. Good. Five, four, three, two, one. Reset. Last time, basic child pose, hips to heels. Good, I wanna add a rock in my body. So think how you're gonna go into your diving your head forward, okay? So I wanna start almost like a quadruped. So I'm gonna arch my back. Good, I wanna pull through, give me a cat stretch. Take it to child pose. And then snake through, arch. Extend up, round. So then you're snaking your body all the way through. So we're moving through your knees, your back, your shoulders, your hips, pressing forward, extending up. If you're more flexible, you can drive through your center, push all the way up, and roll all the way back. Good, really move through your whole spine. So really wanna extend and contract. Get those hips to open up towards the floor. Get the back to round to the ceiling. Give me four more times with control. Really push through your core. Really hold those abs in. Good. Two more. Last one. Good job, and rest. How are we doing? You guys are good? I'm sweating, I hope you are too. All right, let's take your hands on the ground for your quadruped. So think about a table, okay? If you're a nice long table, find your neutral spine. So take your wrists under your shoulders, knees on the hip, hip width apart, okay? If you have bad shoulders or bad elbows or fists or wrists, sorry, you can make two fists. If not, take something to elevate yourself a bit higher so you can take yourself a bit off the ground, okay? Keep yourself in neutral spine, don't over arch, don't over round. So think about your elbows are soft, don't hyperextend. Keep the soft parts facing in, body parts facing out. Let's go to a bit of a cat and cow stretch. Do a few of these. So you find the middle of your spine, so we're gonna find your neutral spine. So right where the top of your head, top of your shoulders, and the top of your tailbone wants to form a nice line. So find your neutral spine here. Okay, keep those abs drawn in. Think about that table, so don't move your shoulders too much or your hips. Keep everything pushing into the ground and squeeze those abs in. I wanna reach one hand forward and then back down. So think how you're gonna reach. Keep energy on all the limbs on the ground. Keep your body nice and stable. So if you are having champagne on the corners of every joint of your hips and shoulders, you don't want to drop it. You want to drink it later, right? Okay, so inhale, exhale, reach forward and back to the same spot. Control those elbows, control your balance. Lengthen forward. Remember, you want to don't shift the weight. So think how you're going to push and transfer weight. On your own, keep pushing and resisting into the mat. So there's a bit of weight bearing, so you really want to strengthen your whole body. Last set, one on each side. Go up and down and switch. Let's keep your hands on the floor. We're gonna do the same thing with your legs. We're gonna stretch behind you and then bring it back to the same spot. So don't do this in your hips. Keep them nice and square. Oops. I'm gonna break my apartment down. Keep going on your own, pushing and squeezing. Good, let's do four more, one leg at a time. Keep breathing into your extension where you stretch that leg out. Exhale, inhale. Last set, come on, push. And switch. Let's add the opposite hand forward. So now you're working on balance and still strengthening your muscles in your whole body. So control, reaching and bending. So think about that whole body being nice and stable as you extend. Normally you want to avoid the changing your spine, so you're using your abs to control. Last four. Switch. But it's not fast. Last three. Switch. Last two. Switch. Last one. And switch. Good. Again, if you need a child pose, go ahead. Grab your water if you need it now. Move your wrist around if your hands are tired. Alright guys, let's work into a bit of rotation, okay? So if you can't sit upright, you can take a book. You can sit on top of the book or a few books, depends on how your spine is. I want us to be able to stay upright, okay? If you don't have a, well you should have a book at home. But if you have a mat, you can also do it with the mat. You can roll the mat up, take it behind, and sit on top. This gives you space in your tailbone and your back to feel more upright. I don't want you to slouch, all right? So let's take your legs, hip width apart. Sorry, as wide as your mat, but just give me like a little V in your legs, okay? I wanna sit my sit bones into the floor, extend my spine tall, keep your abs contracted, have your hands up. Please do not drop your arms. I wanna work on my arm strength against gravity, so you wanna resist. Okay, so don't start to sag and relax. This is already a workout in its own, just holding yourself up, okay? Inhale here. I wanna start to twist to one side, so as I push the air out, I wanna rotate. As you rotate, think about your hips and legs in the same spot, okay? Come back to the center of your body. Inhale there. Exhale, go the other way. So just a nice spine twist. Remember, don't drag your legs and change the shape in your spine. Keep yourself upright. So twist, come to the center with control. Almost very robotic, right? So control, keep your hands the same distance from your chest on each side. Let's do another time. This time you go back to the first where you started. I wanna look, twist as far as I can, and then I wanna look behind my arm, myself. So add my neck, so further rotation. Come back to the center. Inhale here, exhale. Good, add your neck, look behind you. Keep doing that a few times on your own. I'm gonna push the air out as you twist. It gets you to really rotate more, okay? This helps your diaphragm and the abs push to get yourself to really extend and twist. Your neck adds more rotation for your upper back and for your neck muscles, good? Think about your spine, right? You wanna really get good control. Give me your last set. Remember, not about speed, it's about good control. Good job. How do we feel? I hope you feel a bit more malleable. It's gonna get harder. All right. Let's add a spine stretch, okay? So if you're on that, sitting on something, you wanna keep your butt down, your head's gonna start as your anchor. So I wanna start to look forward. So toes, knees, thighs, center of your body. You can relax your shoulders a bit, bring them back up, and then start to peel back up. Think you're against the wall, so take your head off the wall, shoulders,
upper back, middle back, and peel up. Use your abs to resist, right? Think someone's gonna punch you. Really squeeze those abs around forward. And up. Last one, inhale, exhale. Think you're holding a ball. And squeeze the ball into your abs, but don't touch yourself with your hands. Round. Good job. How are those arms? Like ballet arms. Ooh. All right. Let's all go into a basic roll down. So a bit malleable in our spine, I hope. All right. So if you need help, you get your trusty towel. You can take a towel on your back to lay down on to give you some more cushion to give a little bit of oomph to come off or down. Or you can take it underneath your thighs to make handles to grab, okay? So I'll start off with the handles here. I want to lengthen my back, keep your knees up to the ceiling, hips square to the ground. I want to pull my belly button in, okay? My tailbone's going to stay where it's at. Then you're going to slide that penny to roll down bone by bone. So I want to push away to go down slowly. Head goes down last. Inhale, head comes up first. Look to where you're going. Keep your neck long and start to roll up. When you get to the top, extend and start again. Pushing your tailbone forward, pushing your belly button in to go down slowly. Inhale, exhale up. Good, think about how you're gonna move spine, bone by bone into the floor. Really good for your whole back. Control. If you wanna work harder, pull with those biceps. Keep your chest wide to give you more space. You can also use your hands on your thighs. Or if you're stronger, take your hands off in space and just use your own center. Remember, breathing is important, so inhale, exhale, up. Inhale, exhale, down. Good, do three more. Come on, control. Take your time going up. Get your spine to really move. So bone by bone, up off the floor. Bone by bone, back down to the ground. Two more, breathe. Give me your last one. Good. Let's all sit up nice and tall. Same idea. We're gonna add a bit of rotation. Now I wanna work my obliques harder now, okay? So if you have the towel, you can take it underneath your legs again, but we wanna rotate a bit. When you rotate, middle of your chest, align with the knee you're facing. So you can have your hands here if you wanna work harder. But don't let your hips move side to side. Control, okay? If you have that towel, you're here. So I'm gonna have a little bit of a twist. I wanna roll down that side. I lay down, go the other way, and come up the other side. Center yourself. And then I wanna reverse. If you do it with no towel, you're going down. Going other side up. So you're gonna actually work more of obliques. Still working your spine, but it's nice, good control in your abs. Nice and easy. Remember, you're taking your time. You're gonna really work your muscles, work your spine, increase good mobility in your back. Good. Let's do two more. Give me your last one, down, and up. Good, let's reset up with your knees bent. We're gonna roll back into our sit bones, so prepare for a teaser. So when I take my hands underneath my thighs, I bring my legs up, okay, like a tabletop. All right, baby teaser, balancing your sit bones, so feel your bones in your butt. When you feel good, you can take your hands off and balance. Okay, be more flexible, you gotta have your legs straight. Woo! Good, let's hold it for 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Good, we need to stretch again. You can take yourself forward. All right, those were your sit bones for balancing, right? You were here, okay? From laying down, I want to get to that same position. So think about how you're gonna control your lift and your release to go down. So I want to lay down on your back, one leg at a time. So if you need to watch, go ahead. If you know what you're doing, go right away. So you're gonna go take your hands away. I have no space. So you're gonna take your hands away to come up to sit. Pull one leg up, push the other leg down. Inhale, exhale, go down. And switch. Okay, my head and my foot wants to go down at the same time. If you're flexible, the leg goes up straight. Good, do a few more, either bent knee or straight leg. Inhale, exhale, up. Inhale, exhale, down, so control. Don't jerk too much, don't really throw yourself wrong. Use that leg on the floor to help you balance the weight to come up, okay? If you can do this already by now, try to get both legs up. Slow, go down. Inhale, exhale, up. Inhale, exhale, down. With control, reaching up and down. Last two. Try to do both legs, not everyone. If not, continue one leg. Good, give me one more. Good, rest. All right, let's kick up to sit. We're gonna face down into a plank. If you have weak shoulders, bend your elbows, all right? So straighten your legs. You can bend your elbows like this or have your hands straight up, okay? Think about your plank. Push your weight into your arms. Watch out for your elbows still. Widen your chest, abs in, squeeze your butts. Squeeze your butts so tight that they squeeze and squash. I wanna make applesauce, no. Apples, not applesauce, okay? So push into the floor. Lengthen your back, squeeze those abs in, squeeze your butt. Four more. Three, two, one, and rest. Okay, we're gonna add a bit of movement to your legs. So you're gonna think of how you're gonna push your foot and point it behind. Go down. So when I'm thinking about flexing and pointing my leg, so point out and flex down. The objective is to keep your hips square, you still hold your plank form. The elbows are bent or arms are straight. So press away, push. Feel traction in the floor and your mat. Keep the hips square, balance. Four, three, two, one, and rest. All right. Let's go back onto your butt, sitting down. We're gonna roll like a ball. If you need help, you can take the towel to go under your legs. Okay, I'm gonna make a shape. Okay, my shape is to stay in this nice seated position. Knees stay bent. Don't move from like this. Control. Okay, again, if you need to hold the towel, you can go here. All right, I'm gonna roll back to my shoulders. Up to my butt. Control your hips. So don't have your legs move the weights. Use your breathing to go back and forth. Scoop your belly. Balance. Woo! So try to keep your head off the floor. Keep your feet off the ground. Three more. It's fun. Two more. Whee! Give me one last one. Good. Relax. If you can stay here, stay here. I want to work my abs again. So I'm going to take my hands off. If not, hold them, okay? I want to straighten my legs. Push and pull. Push and pull. Let's go. Six. Five. Four. Three, two, one. Good job. Oh, how we feel?
Let's go into an inversion. Are we okay with that? If you have any back issues, you can try to do it seated. So I would suggest going back to roll down and rolling up, okay? If you don't have any back issues, you can try the roll over, okay? So I'm gonna start with my hands on the ground, legs tabletop, flex your feet, lengthen your legs. Legs are hip width apart, okay? Hands on the ground. Bring your butt off the floor, balancing your shoulders. No weight on your necks. I wanna roll down bone by bone, hips are even. When your butt touches the floor, make a small circle. And repeat. Inhale, exhale, come down. All right, that's too difficult. Go back to going here to get your back to move. Almost the same idea, but not upside down. So not inverted, yeah? So if you're doing your inversion, but you're staying nice and controlled, don't put any weight in your neck, control. So lift up and roll down. Use your eyes to see the legs go down evenly on both sides. Your hips are square and over. Two more. Inhale, exhale, up, pushing away, softening down, circling around, and over. Great job. All right, the hard one, boomerang, okay? We're gonna do three exercises that we did in the class, put them all together, okay? So we're gonna first start with a roll down. So we're used to the roll down. So if you need to watch, watch first. I'm gonna roll down bone by bone. Take the hands to grab them under the ground. I roll over. I roll back down from here. When your butt touches, you balance into your teaser. So I'm gonna lift through my core up, okay? So then I'm gonna push straight up, okay? My legs go down, I spine stretch. We did that earlier as well. I come up and reset, all right? I'm gonna have the legs crossed. Squeeze those thighs together, point your toes forward for direction. So if you think about your toes are forward, they go over your head. So you're pushing over. You're pulling down and pointing away. So squeeze the legs. Always keep them together. Only switch when they're behind your head. So first start rolling back. Roll over. Roll down. Teaser. Spine stretch. Come up. And reset, roll back, roll over. Now switch your legs on the overhead, roll down. Teaser and spine stretch, all right? Continue to move like that. Breathing in and out. Switch, roll down, breathe in, and stretch around your back. Roll yourself up. Two more times. Remember to transfer those legs when they're over your head. Keep your abs tight. Woo, sweaty, sweaty, sweaty. Very elegant, right? Woo. One more. Good job. All right, another one. So I'm gonna start with my elbows bending, my fingers go behind my hips, my thumbs go to the front of my hips. I wanna hold myself like Barbie doll hands, right? Make two crab hands. So I wanna go over to the rollover, bend at the elbows, squeeze in the center. Now keep your hips square. Take the weight off your neck, bring those legs up. Okay, I'm gonna bend one knee into my chest like we did earlier, like a bicycle upside down. Push the pedals away. Bicycle upside down, keep those abs tight. Keep the hips square. Push, and push, and push, and push. You can dip your leg behind you, go ahead. But I'm gonna pull into your abs and push up to the ceiling and away. Keep the hips even on both sides. Don't move those hips. Four, three, two, one. Go press the legs together, lower them down, hands off, and roll down slow. Are we good? I'm sure you guys are good. Ready? Stand up.
So the whole body now, we're gonna work on something standing up, okay? So if you wanna do push-ups, you do as many as you want at your own time and own timing, okay? So I'm gonna do a spine stretch. We do everything standing up first. I wanna do what we did earlier. I wanna roll myself down with my head as my anchor, shoulders follow. Good, onto the ground. If you can't reach the floor, bend your knees. Walk with energy in your hands and feet forward into a plank. Push up. You give me as many as you want. Okay, you roll back to your toes. And then you roll up. Inhale, exhale, down. Inhale, exhale, walk away. Inhale, exhale, push up. Take yourself back. And roll up. Give me two more. Inhale, exhale, round down. Walk away. Good, push up. Take yourself back to your toes. And roll up. Last one, come on. Inhale, exhale, round down. Walk away. Give me your push up. Walk back to those toes. And roll up. Good, shake it out. Last part, we work on balance. I'm dripping. Okay, so facing forward, think about your hips being square, nice and even in your sides of the hips. Let's make this a little higher. Okay, so I'm gonna bring one leg up, balance. You can grab the bottom of the thigh, keep those abs in, lengthen your spine. Good, with control, I'm gonna open the leg to the side and then back to the front. And go side, keep the hips forward. So you really wanna work into those hips, standing with your balance, core control, good posture alignment. Good, last one, let's take the legs to the side. I wanna point my toes away, so develop a push and bend. Don't kick, we're not doing combat, that's for later. All right, so you think I'm gonna push and bend. Control, push and bend. Last one, push and bend. Good, bring the leg back to the front. I want you to cover your eye. Remember, you're working on balance, core control. Cover your other eye. Ooh, remember, no dancing, keep your center. Cover both eyes, no cheats. Good, and rest. How was that? Did you manage from wobbling? Ready? Other side, same thing. Inhale, exhale, bring that other leg up. Center yourself, feel good through your body. And again, so to trace the line to the side, opening the hips, but keep them nice and controlled. Good. If you wanna really work on your own center, you can go here, or have your hands relaxed. Control, yeah, don't speed. It's a stretch at the same time. Muscle control, balance, posture and alignment. Good, last one, hold to the side. Same thing, remember, not combat, extend, stretch. And bend and stretch. Keep everything nice and controlled. And stretch and bend. Yes, Lola. Good. Whoa, bring your knee back to the front. Cover the eye. Good, cover your other eye. Cover both eyes. Don't cheat, don't cheat, don't cheat. Give me a hop. Good job, guys. I hope you have fun today during my Pilates class. Send me some feedback if you have time. If not, see you guys soon. Watch out for the schedule. We have classes every day for you. All right, thank you so much. See you around.